What is up, my fellow Munchies? It's your boy Mo here. Today we are at DiMartino's and we're about to get our grub on. Stay tuned. By popular demand, I have been requested to come review this place, and I did get two items, the shrimp po' boy and the turkey giardinara, which I'm pretty sure I just butchered that, but my ESL game not that strong today. So let's start with the turkey giardinara. First, you get that crunch from the muffulatta bun. Pure bliss. Then, as you bite down, you taste the turkey. Then you taste the giardinara, which is like a nice fatty contrast to the very lean turkey. Then you get the artichoke hearts, which honestly is just kind of like filler. But then you taste the spinach, which honestly I feel like did way better than if they would have put lettuce in it. It gives you like that layer that doesn't allow the oil to come through and just kind of make everything soggy. Then after that, you get like that tomato. Last but not least, the sweet pickles. Oh my God, bro. When I tell you the sweetness kind of mends in with all of the other components of this muffulatta, it just brings it full circle. This was an amazing sandwich. I highly recommend this. I promise you, you would not be disappointed. Run over here and get you one. What rating should I give this delectable sandwich? We're gonna give the turkey giardinara 9 munchies out of 10. Must munch. Run over here, get you some, because as one of my great friends always says, it's heaven in your mouth. Honestly, my only complaint to it is I don't really feel like the artichoke heart brings anything to the table. Other than that, dude, everything. Crunch, sweetness, savoriness. It's just, the whole sandwich is just complete. It has all the right textures, all the right flavor profiles, just to make the perfect sandwich that you want. I'm still dreaming about that one. Screw counting sheeps. Count turkey giardinaras before you go to sleep. Next up on this food adventure, the shrimp po' boy. Y'all know I'm trying to find the best shrimp po' boy in the city, so let's see if this is it. Took that first bite, po' boy bread, same crunch factor, bro. Same crunch factor. That's what I'm talking about. When you bite into any type of bread, you need to get that crunch and munch in your life. Question is, are you about that crunch life? Just let me know in the comments below. Hashtag crunch life. Hot sauce break. Let's get down to everything else. Crunch on the bread, amazing. The shrimp was cooked perfectly. However, the flavor did not bring its A game on that night. The vegetables were fresh and crisp, which is what you would expect from a good sandwich anyway. Honestly, bread makes or breaks a sandwich. Like my boy Art would say, you got poo bread, you gonna have a poo sandwich. Overall, guys, solid po' boy, but I do recommend y'all gotta step up y'all fried shrimp game, DiMartino's. Now for the rating. I'm gonna give the shrimp po' boy sandwich 8 munchies out of 10. I'm not even gonna lie, guys, that bread is what made the difference. Like, if I could find out where to get that bread, I would put that on every single sandwich out there. Let's be real, wherever DiMartino's is getting that bread, keep doing it. Just imagine if their shrimp was just as good as that bread game. This would have easily been a 9.
If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button, smash that subscribe, and I know there are some of y'all out there watching from the bushes, but not jumping out to join the Munchies Nation. Guys, all you gotta do is click that button and you'll join the greatest nation of all, the Munchies Nation. And last but not least, tap that bell. You get more future food reviews from your boy, Mo Munch. And as always, until next time, munch on.